Guys, it's ADW, and today we're going to be building most of the architecture of the graphics card. Now, notice how I said building. There is going to be very little explanation from me in this episode. You should already understand most of what you're doing. If you have a question, please do leave a comment and I will answer it. Also, this is a general thing about anything I make on my channel, but I want to reinstate it here because it particularly applies to this hardware. Copy whatever you want. I am a big believer in what Pablo Picasso said, good artists copy, great artists steal. Because if you're new to this stuff, there's a lot that you can learn from stealing, and if I didn't want you to use this stuff, I wouldn't upload tutorials on anything in the first place. So you should know if I upload something, there is nothing wrong with you using it. Also, I'm going to be using the same style as I did for my first Building a Redstone Computer series, even though this is, I guess this still sort of counts as a Building a Redstone Computer series. And by that, I mean that I'm going to be skipping over the building parts of the video and sort of explaining what I'm doing, and then at the end, there's going to be a huge bit of fast-forward footage of me doing all of the really dirty work for this thing, put to music or something like that. Now, before we start building, the first thing you need to come up with whenever you're starting a project like this is you have to have some goals. You want to know what your computer is going to be able to accomplish when you're building your instruction set so that you can make sure that your computer accomplishes it. You don't want to be in the awkward position where you're caught halfway through this thing and you have to make a huge decision about functionality that will have enormous consequences for what your computer is going to do and not know what you want your computer to be able to do. You definitely want to have all of that sort of thing planned out in advance. That said, there are three goals that I have for this GPU, and they are things that I'm going to be going over in PowerPoints that are going to be in this series. I want this GPU to be able to render lines and vectors, or lines that objects can travel across on the screen. I want it to be able to load images onto the screen from memory. Most specifically, I want it to be able to display a number in decimal notation onto any point at the screen from a binary number that it is given. I also want it to be able to do multiplication and division fast so that a computer that controls it can use it to multiply and divide numbers fast if it wants to. We can probably add more programs into the microcode, so if there is something that you think should be included and we have leftover ROM, let me know and we might build it. So with that out of the way, I'm going to build the first thing that we're going to need to build, which is the memory. We're going to be building the memory first because out of all the things that we're going to be building, memory needs to be built off of the most. And by that, I mean that we need to have the memory there in the first place so that we can build off of it, because the way that we're going to be building this thing on the whole and the way that it functions really requires us to build off of the memory more than any other device that we're going to be using. Now, I'm going to be using a memory design that I have developed myself, and it's special because not only does it scale diagonally, it also has the read-write commands on the outside of the design, and this is going to be important for something that we're going to be going over later in this video, so we'll see why that's useful in just a second. Alright, so I feel like we want that village over there to have a nice view of our screen. We're going to be building, I don't exactly know which direction the screen is going to be facing, or at least I'm not sure if I can decide at this point, but I'm going to try to get it to be facing that village, maybe. So, yeah, this build is now officially dedicated to that village. For no reason whatsoever. Other than that I just needed some sort of orientation. So, this down here, what we're building first, this is actually the read mechanism, not the write mechanism. So what's going to be going on is, first of all, we need to block that off, and for tileability purposes, we also need to block that off. And this is 4 wide, so we're also going to need to add that on. So this is basically just going to disable the signal, which is going to be coming in here. It needs to be a slab, because the next one up is going to be here. And that also means we're going to need something there. And, yeah. So then this is the repeater that we're going to end up locking. And yeah, it's going to look something like this. And then we're going to do is we're actually going to be in repeater heaven for a bit here. No, that's not how this one works. There's going to be other ones where that's how it's going to end up working, but not this one. And yeah, so that's the right mechanism. We're using two repeaters here, but that's just what we need to do to get this wire to be above this wire, which is a big deal. Again, we're going to be seeing why that is later. And let's see what else. Oh yes, the orientation of this matters a lot, because depending on the direction that this design faces is going to determine the direction that data has to flow. And I'm going to have to think about this to make sure that this is oriented the right way for us to do that over there. So let's see. And while I'm at it, I should also probably, or rather while I'm thinking about it, I should probably build the next one of these guys up. Just so that we see that this thing's tiling well. And like that, up like that, slab there. Down like that, and around like that. And yeah, am I missing anything? I feel like I'm missing something. Yes, I am missing actually a whole lot here. Yeah, I need to start out by making that, and not placing a block there. And then let's go up like that. Sorry about that. I've got a bit of a cough going on right now. Otherwise, though, I'm fine. So we can attach that up like that, and as you can see, everything is tiling perfectly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make 8 bytes of this, and those 8 bytes are going to be a very specific part of the memory that we really need to start with, and is the reason that we're starting with the memory in the first place. I'll check if I need to check if the orientation is correct on these. I think that it is, because the repeaters for signal extension need to go like this. And then when that happens, that happens. So yeah, these are oriented correctly. Yeah, so just know that looking at the design like this, actually these aren't oriented correctly. These are oriented incorrectly. Because for this, the repeater is going to be facing this way, and this direction, the opposite direction that the repeater is facing has to be towards the the ALU in the design, just because we can't put the repeater like this, because then when we don't have redstone dust out there, that's not going to power that. But yeah, so I'm going to need to flip this around, just know that the right command is going to flow that way for this design, so make sure that it's facing in the direction that you want it to flow. But anyway, I have rambled enough about this, so I'm going to go ahead, go off camera, reorient this so that the village can see this eventually, and I'm also gonna scale this up to 8 bits, so I'll see you guys then. Okay, before we get started on the next part of this video, I want to quickly go over how to extend, how to repeat these. The best way that I've found to repeat these is to add in the repeater right about here. Now you need to do this every 4 memory addresses because they're 4 wide, so 4 times 4 is 16, and 15 plus 1 for the repeater is 16 blocks, so yeah, that's how that works. Sorry, that wasn't the best explanation, but anyway, so to do this, the problem is that you can probably tell there's going to be a lot of wire conflict. So the first step to resolving this is to break that, because we don't need it anymore. And then the other thing we need to do is we need to, don't do that, do that, and then power that like that. And yeah, so then what we need to do is we're going to need to replace all of these dusts with stuff like that. And then you just need to do it on every single one of them. First of all, after you've done this once, you should be just fine to... that's why you need to break the redstone. Like you actually need to do it so that that doesn't happen, by the way. So once we've done that, then what you can do is you can just stack this for the rest of yours. I chose to stack 8 times in the first place, and then I'm going to stack this again to finish that up. But yeah, I want to do a few more just so that to make sure that you guys have got the general idea. So block that off, that. And then for this one, this next one down here. So here is the repeater from here. I've broken the redstone. Now this needs to be moved down one, like that. That redstone needs to be broken and that needs to be blocked off. And yeah. So that's about it for this part, and I'll see you once I've done this and unstacked that to over there. So now that we have finished building the first 8 bytes, we need to go over some of the functionality of the graphics card. The first section of memory we're going to be talking about is these first 8 bytes. As you can imagine, the CPU is going to be way too fast to implement proper pointers. And you can't really implement pointers into accumulators in the first place because there's only one register. So where are you going to store the new information? But we still want the device to be Turing complete. So I've decided to use these 8 bytes of RAM specifically designed to have 2 reading modes. Read from that address, as in read the actual data in that register, and read to where that address is pointing. So that would give us working pointers, but how are we going to get signals from these 8 bytes of memory into both decoders in the main memory and onto the output bus of the memory? And the answer to that lies in the design that we're using. If you look at the memory decoders that I've set up for this design, so I haven't actually added address decoders into this thing yet, but you can see based on these wires what we're going to be talking about. These are going to be the address decoding wires. These are going to be the wires that are containing the binary number that is being decoded. And as you can see from the orientation of these, they are just staggered tiling diagonally in the same way that the memory is. And this is the reason that we actually have read and write commands on the outside, because I haven't done the lines that I have up here down there. But the point of these lines is that we're going to be able to have the decoder physically built onto this device. Yeah, it's going to be pretty slick. Now, the reason that we want these things to be diagonal is that this way they are in the same orientation as these output wires down here. And that is going to be a big deal, because not only is that going to make the redstone more compact and cleaner, it's also going to make the pointers quite fast and much more practical for this design. And we need this thing to be as fast as possible, because it's going to be working with a very fast CPU. We want to be doing fast graphical processing in the first place. So our next step is going to be to build the main memory and connect the read output of this to the addressing decoders, or at least move them to where they are eventually going to be. So yeah, I'm going to do that, and I'll see you guys when I'm done. So there is a bit of a problem that I've just found trying to get the output from these, pointer RAM addresses out to the top here, which is where we're going to need them. And so I've devised a few cunning schemes that I'm pretty sure are going to work. I've tested them not perfectly for like one part of it, but I'm very confident that this is going to work if I change a few things. It's just that when I say a few things, I mean a lot of things, so I wanted to record this just to make sure that you know the system that I am using to get this stuff up here. So the first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to need to move this guy over, and as you can see, that's immediately going to interfere with this. The first thing that I did is I changed the orientation of these repeaters, of the write commands. So now they're facing this way, and that freed up some space in the front that I needed. to do this, just because of signal strength issues, by the way. That's all that this revolves around. So now we have this issue right here, which is that this is powering this when it shouldn't. So the way we have to deal with that is we just have to go back to the normal way of doing this, only we actually keep that guy there now. And yeah, so it looks like that is going to work. So I'm going to get rid of all of these blocks. Not those ones. Don't go randomly around breaking blocks. All of these guys. And then all of these. And then we need to replace all of these with that. And there we go. So now that we have that done, I believe what we do now is we're going to take this up, and as you can see, it dies out there. So what we're going to do is we're going to do one of these guys, right? Yeah. And we're going to leave that block in there so that it can power that repeater. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing for this guy. And yeah, so that's going to, let's see how many blocks across is it. It's across two. Then we get the first block, second block like that, and then out like that. And these are going to be the dusts that we're going to use to power that. So yeah, that's just the thing I'm going to do. I'm going to get back to building this now. But yeah, again, I wanted to share that just because this system is a bit convoluted. If you're following by block, it might not be. Oh dear. Anyway, yeah, I should probably get back to just doing what I usually do. Okay, that is looking pretty huge, if you ask me. Yeah. So in addition to the 8 bytes we originally had, which are over there, by the way, the village is over here. Maybe I should turn clouds off for this. They're at the exact annoying height. Maybe this view is just better. But yeah, at that far end are the first 8 bytes we built, and here in the middle is 40 more bytes that I added. So there's two things that I want to explain how they work before we call this it quits for the commentary for this episode. The first is about some of the memory. So the first thing we need to talk about is that the CPU is going to be next to one end of this thing. Specifically, it's going to be that far end away from the 8 bytes that we talked about earlier. And this is a big deal because of signal extension. Every 4 bytes we get away from the CPU, the memory gets 2 ticks slower. There's one memory to get it back to the CPU, and one memory to get it back to the CPU, one tick to get it back to the CPU, and one tick to get it from the CPU into the memory. For reading, this doesn't matter, because for faster reads, we will just send the read command in later. But for writing, it's going to matter a lot, because the longer it takes for the information to move away from the CPU, the more time the CPU needs to wait if it needs to access that information again. So this effectively sets up a sort of memory hierarchy, and we're going to need to manage the faster memory when we are using this thing's microcode. The second thing that we're going to need to talk about is what we need to do to make this memory fully functional. We need to figure out the commands that it's going to be given and where those commands are going to be coming from so that we can build circuitry that implements it. The first thing we need to understand about the functionality of this memory as a whole is that, like I mentioned earlier, it's completely synced. We need to make sure that the signal coming from the CPU will arrive at the same time as the memory address that it needs to be saved to. So to do that, we need signals going along the decoder lines in the exact same direction as the data is flowing. That way, they move through the memory device at the exact same rate. So what I'm going to be building today are decoders for the memory and a connection to the output pointer of the bus to the right addressing bus. So I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time.
your troubles and doubts, given me everything inside and out, and love strange, so real in the dark. Think of the tender things that we were working on. Slow change may pull us apart. When a light gets in your heart, baby, don't you forget about me. Forget about me, I'll be alone, dancing. Yeah.